Hey, look, you want to get a bite tonight? There's this, this new Cuban place just opened on the Lower East Side. Supposed to be good.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You and I?
Yeah, or other people.
That sounds nice.
Yeah.
I would like that.
Finally.
Thank you very much.
Mark, hey.
It's a bloodbath up here. Morgan's stock has lost half its value. Down to 2310. It's in a free fall. Clients wanted to talk to you about pulling their money. I mean, it's now or never, Mark. We gotta sell. Mark. Mark, can you hear me?
Mark, are you there?
Mark.
Paulson and Bernanke just left the White House. There's going to be a bailout.
Well, they had to. Right? I mean, paper markets were
collapsed. They knew.
Cash would stop coming out of ATMs. They had to backstop this.
They knew the taxpayers would bail them out. They weren't being stupid. They just didn't care.
Yeah, because they're fucking crooks. But
at least we're going to see some of them go to jail. Right? I mean, they're going to have to break up the banks.
I don't know. I don't know. I have a feeling that in a few years, people are going to be doing what they always do when the economy tanks. They will be blaming immigrants and poor people.
But Mark was wrong. In the years that followed, hundreds of bankers and rating agencies executives went to jail. The SEC was completely overhauled, and Congress had no choice but to break up the big banks and regulate the mortgage and derivatives industries. Just kidding. Banks took the money the American people gave them, and they used it to pay themselves huge bonuses and lobby the Congress to kill big reform. And then they blamed immigrants and poor people, and this time even teachers. And when all was said and done, only one single banker went to jail. This poor schmuck, Kareem Sarageldin from Credit Suisse. He hid a few billion in mortgage bond losses, something most of the big banks did on a good day during the crisis.
Mark, can we sell now?
I mean, the fund will make almost $1 billion. You'll clear 200 mil, Mark.
You know, once we sell, we'll be just like the rest of them. You know that.
No, we're not. We're not the bad guys here. We didn't defraud the American people and prey on their dreams of owning a home. All right, they did.
Now we get to kick them in the teeth.
$1 billion.
That's right. But we got to close out our position or it could be zero. I mean, it's now or never, Mark.
Okay. Sell it all.
Thank you.